a wise virgin from among the number of the prudent, who went forth with lighted lamp to meet Christ. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. My brethren, as we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us not pause to acknowledge our sins. I confess to Almighty God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, and what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask this of Mary, of the Virgin, of all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy, Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, who set St. Catherine of Siena on fire with divine love in her contemplation of the Lord's Passion and her service of your Church, grant, through her intercession, that your people, participating in the mystery of Christ, may ever exalt in the revelation of his glory, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. There broke out a severe persecution of the church in Jerusalem, and all were scattered throughout the countryside of Judea and Samaria, except the apostles. Devout men buried Stephen and made a loud lament over him. Saul, meanwhile, was trying to destroy the church, entering house after house and dragging out men and women. He handed them over for imprisonment. Now those who had been scattered went out about preaching the word. Thus Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed the Christ to them. With one accord, the crowds paid attention to what was said by Philip. When they heard it, saw the signs that he was doing. For unclean spirits, crying out in a loud voice, came out of many possessed people, many paralyzed and crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Responsor of Psalm, Alleluia, Alleluia. Sing joyfully to God all the earth. Sing praise to the glory of his name. Proclaim his glorious praise. Say to God, how tremendous are your deeds. Alleluia. Let all on earth worship and sing praise to your name. Come and see the works of God, his tremendous deeds among the children of Adam. Alleluia. He has changed the sea into dry land, though the river they passed on foot. Therefore let us rejoice in him. He rules by his might forever. masses this day at the parish are being offered for the following intentions: for the soul of Raymond Bellflower, for the soul of Joe Mazio, and for the souls of Antonio, Katarina, and Linda Ganga. My brothers and sisters, today's Gospel from St. John is from chapter 6, where we have the Eucharistic discourse of Jesus to his disciples. And how appropriately that the Church gives us this text of readings from St. John, specifically on the Eucharist, that Jesus explained that he's the bread of life, but that we read this in this Easter season, because it is the risen Christ who is present to us in the Holy Eucharist. Some people ask, well, when did Jesus really give us the Eucharist? Well, it began at the Last Supper and it's completed on Easter Sunday. So the Eucharist itself is that whole sacrifice of himself from his passion, his death, and his resurrection. And every time we celebrate the Mass, that's what we're entering into, that mystery of those 3 days of Holy Week we call the Triduum. And so the risen Christ is the presence of himself in the Eucharist. And let us appreciate that, because the Eucharist gives us strength, the Eucharist gives us hope. The Eucharist is what moves us on. Why? Because it's the risen Christ, and the risen Christ is our hope. similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullest of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, your blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, the mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. The Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, to wait the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom, the power, the glory of yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, said your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins and on the faith of your church, but graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." The peace of the Lord be with you always, with your spirit. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot Let us pray. May the heavens